Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our radio show. I'm Tristan Gardner, and you're listening to Your Sound 89.9 KWAR. We'll let you get to know us a little better right about now. As you may have known, I am Tristan Gardner. I'm from Milo, Iowa, and I'm going to be a senior at Southeast Warren.
I'm Brooke Johnson, and I'm from North Tama, and I'm going to be a senior.
I'm Andy Edson. I'm from Nashville Plainfield, so I'm not too far from Wartburg, about a good 25-minute drive. I'm going to be a senior also.
And I'm Nick Brincks. I live in Carroll, Iowa, and I will be a junior at Kemper this year.
We have a great show for you tonight, so stay tuned to Your Sound, 89.9 KWAR.
We're the students from IBA Broadcasters Workshop at Wartburg College in Waverly, Iowa. You're listening to Your Sound, 89.9 KWAR.
You're listening to Your Sound, 89.9 KWAR. It's 6:37. I am looking forward to this program tonight, and I am also looking forward to our broadcast on WTV8 tomorrow night. What do you say to that?
I agree.
Sounds good. All right. Well, I'm Andy. First of all, I got to give a shout out to Miss Stacy White, who's out of Plainfield, Iowa. So, hey there. Now I think we're going to turn this over. The Dark Knight, the Batman movie, came out about a week and a half ago, I would say, and there's been a lot of fluff about it. We've been talking about it in the studio a little bit. I think we should take the point of view from someone who hasn't gone yet. So, Brooke, you want to start us out with what you're thinking about it?
Well, you're right. I haven't seen it, but I have seen the original Batman movie, Batman Begins, I think it is. And I've seen a lot of Heath Ledger's different movies, like Night's Tale. Just totally loved it. So I was excited to see about it. But from what I've heard, he's really kind of a scary character in it, so.
Yeah, that's very true.
He played the part very well, and it's a shame that... he's not around anymore.
And you know, the thing a lot of people have been talking about is if he was still around, would it have been still such a big hit and everything?
That's very true. I agree with that. Nick, you want to tell us what you thought of the movie? You've seen it, right?
Yeah, I went with some friends about a week ago, and I was extremely confused. One of my friends tried to explain it to me. It pretty much flew all the way over my head into the next county. I had absolutely no idea what was going on, because I've never seen any of the Batman movies, and seeing The Dark Knight first probably wasn't the best decision, but it was a good movie, just very confusing for me.
Yeah, I would say that I didn't like it as much because I'm more of a good guy kind of guy instead of a villain. So it didn't have quite as much about Batman, and it was more about the Joker, which Heath Ledger did an amazing job. We all got to agree on that. But I think we'll get going on with our next song now. You've been listening to Your Sound 89.9.
KWAR.
We're best friends.
You're listening to Your Sound 89.9 KWAR. I'm Nick. And over to Brooke now.
Well, since we were already talking about movies, we're going to give you the list of the top 10 highest grossing movies of all time. And I'm going to start at our lowest number, number 10. Coming in at number 10 is Spider-Man 3 in 2007. Number 9 is Shrek 2 in 2004. And number 8 is Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire in 2005.
Number 7, Jurassic Park from 1993. Number 6, The Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers in 2002.
Coming in at number 5 was Star Wars Episode 1, mind you, The Phantom Menace, from 1999. And number 4 was Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone from 2001.
At number 3 was the Paris, Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Man's Chest in 06. Number two was The Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King in 2003.
Hold on. But we just want to make sure we get this straight. It was The Pirates of the Caribbean. It's a new one. It was popular in Canada.
It's Nick's favorite movie, actually. He likes to watch pirates.
I'm not gonna lie. But at number one, Titanic from 1997, grossing over $1.8 billion. Speaking of Titanic, I think y'all know where this one's headed. You're listening to Your Sound 89.9 KWAR. Back on Your Sound 89.9 KWAR, and Brooke, Tristan, and Andy, everyone loves pets, right?
Right.
Well, I don't know about that.
Well, most people do anyway.
Nick really likes parrots.
And cats, but that's that's beside the point. Okay, the top 10 pet names of all time, as voted on by a selected panel of judges somewhere, somewhen.
Or just made up that we found.
Possibly. Maybe even on YouTube, but we don't know.
For the beginning pet owner.
Okay. Starting out at number 10.
Number 10 is coming in as Lady. Number 9 is Bonnie. And number 8 is Buster.
Number 7 is Sam. A very good name. Number 6. Is Jack, like in Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water.
Number 5 is Lucy, the first one that I kind of somewhat have a personal connection to on the list because my friend has a dog named Lucy. Otherwise, I've never heard any animals name this. And number 4 is Ben, which never heard that one either for an animal. Maybe I'm just weird.
Number 3 is Molly. Number 2, the most famous unicorn on YouTube, Charlie. And the number one pet name, Max.
That's a very common name for anybody.
Yeah, there's a lot of dogs out there named Max as well as other things. But
I don't know. I have a lot of pets at home, but I don't have any of those names on my animals.
What kind of pets do you have?
Well, I have 7 cats, a guinea pig, and a dog. And I have a Polly and a Dolly, but no Molly. So,
Tristan, how about you?
We have 1 cat and 1 dog. Yes, Evan, I'm talking about your dog, Buddy.
And Andy?
Buddy actually should have been on that list, I think. But we live on a farm, so we have a lot of cats running around and a pooch. And then I got some cows going, too. I think we have the most unique kitten name, though, with Chicken McNuggets. So I think we win that one.
Yeah, we got 7 cats at home, and that's about it. 3 of them were just born within the last month, so they're pretty small, just learning how to crawl out of their little box now. But they're very cool, and as I said, I like cats, so oh well. But you're listening to Your Sound 89.9. We'll be back. We're going back with some awesome color.
It's 7:01, and you're listening to Your Sound 89.9 KWAR Waverly.
All right, so you're back with Your Sound 89.9 KWAR, and we're talking now about ways to stay cool in the summer. In case you didn't notice, it was kind of hot today, kind of humid, kind of sticky. So we're going to pass this one over to Brooke. What's the best way to stay cool for you?
Well, I love air conditioning. So what I like to do is if it's really hot, you just have to walk into a really cool down building just long enough to get that refreshing breeze of walking into a cold building. It feels awesome.
I like the air conditioning too. It's so refreshing.
True that. Aqua is always good, as they say. Nick, you got something?
dumping cold water over my head is pretty fun, not gonna lie.
I would agree with that one too. Well, for any of you listeners out there, we want you to call in with ways that you stay cool. And our request line is 319-352-8306. That's 319-352-8306 with any ways you have to stay cool. Coming up now is Fountains of Wayne with Stacy's Mom.
Welcome back to Your Sound 89.9 KWAR. And folks, we haven't gotten any calls in about how to stay cool in the summer, and we just want to know how that is possible. It is hot out there.
I thought of another one, actually. If you take ice cubes or ice water, if you will, whatever, take cold water and pour on the old wrists, the underside of the wrists. That works pretty dang good, I've found.
Anybody else got any other suggestions?
Before I went to Arkansas, I just thought I'd test out by putting ice cubes before I filled my water bottle with water, and it actually worked. And I did that in Arkansas, too.
You can run through the garden hose, put a sprinkler on it, have some fun in the yard. That's always fun to do with the family, or by yourself if you have nothing better to do.
You have a lot of sense.
Exactly.
When all else fails, head to the local pool.
Of course, try using sunscreen, wouldn't you say, Brooke? Is sunscreen pretty good to use, like,
yeah,
on your legs?
So.
Yeah, sunscreen is pretty good to use. He's kind of making fun of me there. I got some serious burns going on over here on my
legs.
Long
story.
What was that, like, first-degree burns, was it?
Third-degree burns.
Amputated your legs, I think?
I did not amputate my legs.
I also like the pool idea. Oh, and I got a song from one of the characters from Sesame Street. They're in the pool, they're out of the pool. That's funny.
Good old Sesame Street, bringing back the good old days.
Okay, we're going to move back into the music here with Ben Folds and Landed.
Home tonight. I'm coming back home.
Welcome to Your Sound, 89.9 KWAR. We're back talking some more with you, and here in a few minutes, we're going to be kicking out of here and sending it to Group 2. So you guys have anything you'd like to say?
We're Group 1, by the way. That means number one for the best out of all the groups.
Numero uno.
You got it.
We've had fun. We've messed up a few times, obviously, but that's what you get when you learn.
That's true. Celine Dion won't be being played anytime soon in my house, so I've had my filling for the year or century, probably.
That was all Andy, let me tell you.
Nick was gonna let you. Don't you worry. Don't even let him pass it over.
What a pun.
Yeah, you guys should be able to see what's going on in this studio. They were over there singing falsetto voice to it and rocking out.
Very well, might I add. Very well. That makes up for the falsetto.
It was kind of disturbing, but yes.
It was fun. You're supposed to have fun in the radio. That's what it's all about.
I wish I could do this some more, but I have to leave too in a few minutes too.
So we'll be kicking it to Group 2 with 4 other people instead of us. And we've had a great time talking to you guys today. Sorry, 3 other people. We had a great time talking to you guys today. I'm Brooke.
And I'm Tristan Gardner.
And I'm Nick.
And I'm Andy.
You've been listening to Your Sound, 89.9 KWAR. Make sure you tune in for the next group and for our show later tonight at 10.
We're out of here.
Good night.
I tear my heart open. I sold myself short.